Hello, Dr. Ray. Welcome back to Ingredients for a Better Life, episode 5. How are you? How you doing over there?
I'm doing great, Jay. Good to see you back on Ingredients for Life.
First, let's jump right into this common topic that a lot of people have been asking on the phone consult is hair transplants and what their options are. If even they say when they call in, do you guys do hair transplants? And you know, how many grafts can I get and all this stuff? So question is, if you could just, because I'm not real familiar with this, and, you know, what is a hair transplant for one? And, you know, how's it done? I know you, in your past, you used to, you know, one of the best in the biz over there in Beverly Hills, and you guys were doing A-list celebrities, you know, to the stars, you know, movie stars with their hair transplants. So just wanted to know, you know, exactly why and when you stopped. And also, if you could discuss, you know, what people currently in showbiz are doing and what those A-list clients are doing for their hair loss and their genetic hair loss problems.
Well, that's a very good question, Jay. And as you mentioned, I was a hair transplant surgeon, and we did have an office in Beverly Hills where we did see some of the A-list celebrities. And at that time, 25 years ago, that's all that we had to offer was the hair transplant. And at that time, we were one of the first clinics offering the single follicular unit transplant. So
say that three times real fast. Say that three times real fast.
Seamless. So very difficult for people to notice. But I always knew that moving hair cells from one place to another place was never the cure. That you never solved anything. There was a riddle inside the body that still needed to be resolved. So as our research was unfolding, I still wanted to have that background, that skill set to be able to transplant some of the cases, Jay, in case we could not resolve the biochemical imbalance that caused it, we would still have the transplant surgery procedure available. And when I started offering Stop and Regrow, the first 5 years, I would offer to the patients, you know, stay on for 1 year. Let's see if we can resolve it and gather enough evidence to share with you that it's working for you. And if it doesn't work, Jay, for whatever reason, right? And for whatever reason, if it doesn't work, I'll offer you a credit towards the hair transplant, which was much more expensive. And after 5 years, Jay, how many hair transplants did I do?
Big zero. None.
Jay, I couldn't do the transplant today if I needed to save your life or my life. So good thing the program works every time. As long as we get to the molecular cause, we can resolve it. So, but it's a common question we get, Jay, is, hey, what about a transplant? And we actually see probably 30% of our patients are after the transplant and they've realized they made the mistake and they realize they can't keep it up. But there's a way that we can resolve and help those patients as well. But it happens so frequently, Jay, that we have a slide, and I'll bring it up and share it with you if you don't mind. And
not
you can
at all.
Share this with your listeners here. People ask, hey, doctor, you know, why did you get started? And, you know, necessity is the mother of invention, right? As it was said in Plato in the Republic. So it happened to me. So I resolved it for myself and then shared it with other people. But why not a hair transplant, Jay? Well, the day of the procedure, you're going to put some holes up there, right? And surgical procedures to the top of your scalp are going to damage the underlying follicular blood supply. And you and I care a lot about keeping ourselves intact, and we want the blood supply intact. And we want you to have as healthy a blood supply as you can have to all over your body, and we don't want to damage it. So number one, this damages the underlying blood supply, and then it kills some of those miniaturized hairs because they don't get enough blood supply to stay, and those follicles will end up dying. And then you run out of the donor supply. So you have 100,000 hairs on your head. If you lose 50,000, Jay, and you're moving 3,000 at a time and you can do three cases, you do the math, right? 10,000 for 50,000 is 1 out of 5, is a 20% coverage. And what will happen is, right, Jay, so this person 10 years later, hair loss continues and continues, three transplants, $12,000 each, $36,000, and wouldn't want to stay like this because, as you notice here, the hair continues to recede back, and then you've lost even more, and then you're left with just this piece back here, and they want to just shave the head completely, right? So we think instead of just putting in some hairs that last for a little while, let all the hairs come back.
And that's not going to stop hair loss, right? I mean, you're still going to, the transplant's not going to stop your hair from falling out, right, Doc? It's not going to cause, it's not going to stop what's causing your hair loss.
You're right. You're right, Jay. So the cause is an underlying molecular imbalance caused by a genetic enzyme defect, caused by a defect in the DNA, caused by those the DNA you receive from mom and dad. So we can use deductive reasoning to figure out the cause, and then we can create the supplement to resolve it for every single person. But this patient came to see me, Jay, and he said, "Hey, doc, I got two beautiful children and a wife. I want some hair. I want a hair transplant." And I said, "How about we look at your biomarker report card, correct some errors if we find them?" And this is him 14 months later. And you could have never done this with a hair transplant, but this was the more natural approach. So this was him 14 months later. And then how did he look 9 years later, Jay? Even better. So we help you get into a good lifestyle today with nutrition support, with supporting enzyme defects with our supplement. And then we help you get into a better future for the next 5, 6, 10 years. And we've had patients working with us for up to 10, 15 years now.
Is the transplant an option for them? So the answer really is, you know, not really. It doesn't sound to me like you're going to get those positive attributes of the other parts of the program either with that, you know? So
absolutely. You're not going to figure out the cause. You're still going to have a genetic enzyme defect that's causing a hormone imbalance inside your body that's causing other cells to have problems. So yep. You have 100 trillion cells, but only 200 different types of them. The hair cell doesn't like the defective imbalance. The prostate cell doesn't like the defective imbalance. The skin cells don't like the defective imbalance. The list goes on and on. So once you correct the errors and you correct the hormone balance, the hair cells like it and grow back like mine, Jay. The yep. skin cells like it and they don't have any problems like mine, Jay. The prostate cells don't grow. The muscle cells like it. So the list goes on and on. So it's about getting rid of superstition, using true science to understand the cause, and using a little bit of logic and maybe a little bit more science with the first law of thermodynamics, we can teach and educate anyone on how molecules turn into hormones that turn into a chemistry that'll help the hair cells respond and grow and be as healthy as long as possible.
Yeah, and from what I understand too, I had another question is, usually, the best results after a transplant, they're not immediate, right? Doesn't it take a while to see, you know, the best results? Can you just walk through the process a little bit of how it works?
So with a transplant, some people will tell you there's a lot of pain. And with the anesthesia, we got to a point where there was less pain. Also, you mentioned the hair growing. It doesn't grow from the beginning. It takes a few weeks to grow, but once it starts to grow, it does grow. It grows thick, beautiful hair that will last forever, but they're going to be sprigs of hairs that grow, and you're going to be able to see right through them, Jay.
Yeah.
So when you damage that blood supply, you can never put them as close together as God put them together. So you can only put them as close together to keep that blood supply separated so that you can nourish that new blood, that new follicle, to make sure it lives. So the hair that you saw an hour before and after is not possible, not nearly possible with a hair transplant. That's a joke. So
yeah.
The goal is to resolve the problem, get a new epigenetics, a new chemistry inside your body, and live as the best quality of life as you can for as long as you can, if you are lucky enough to find stop and regrow.
Well, just jumping onto that topic of how close together you could transplant is, I also heard that only 50% of density, once the surrounding hairs are gone, you only get 50% density. Is something like that right?
That's a good number if you were to use a percentage. There might be physicians that'll sell you 60%, 80%. At the end of the day, it doesn't resolve the underlying problem, and you can never put them as close together as they need to be, and it's pretty obvious. The A-list celebrities today are choosing the route to get their bodies in optimal yeah. health and getting their muscle tone and everything else in better working function, as opposed to just moving hair cells around. That's kind of an old way of looking at it. We did that 40 years ago.
Yeah, for sure. And just to jump into something positive, to segue to next week, for November, I was pretty strict about that stop and regrow, you know, protein, you know, every 2 to 3 hours type thing, especially with your recommendation on the bookend, the morning and the evening protein. Uh-huh. And I swear that the hair and nails are growing faster just with that extra protein, you know, consistently. So maybe next week we can talk about protein in the bloodstream and how protein affects immunity. Yeah, so just keep dropping the questions down in the comments section and then we'll address them as they come. Dr. Ray, thanks for your time. Thanks for all the good work you're doing there, and take care of yourself. We'll see you next week.
Thank you very much, Jay. Have a great and blessed rest of your day.
You as well.